Back there, Pat, to get it. That's not it either. the bear back then. Remember we flew to Philadelphia, remember? No, remember we flew to Philadelphia? For costumes, remember?
Right, Gina
was in there, but Carol and I flew to Brooks Van Horn in Philadelphia to get costumes. We went with sketches. We had no costume designer, but these are Brooks Van Horn's costumes. And Jeannie is not in the scene yet. No.
Say when?
Is that Jeannie?
Yeah, on stage right.
Is it correct? Stage right.
Right there. Bob, do you remember the actress? Do you remember her name?
No.
How do you remember her name?
That's
this is Jim, Dunny, and Paul and I were offices in a big house over on the corner here. Right on the corner. There were a lot of houses. And unheated and all. But Bill Blue people came over one day and he wanted to audition for something. And Jim said to him, "Well, I want to see you without your shirt on." Because he was going to do that, you know, he was going to have to show his upper body.
On this one?
In your blue program proceeding, Ralph's name is spelled Bunderman.
Sorry, it's Ralph. And in the middle is, he taught, Howard, remember, he taught at Pittsburgh.
He was never here.
Ohio Valley.
Yes, Ohio Valley's going this week. Okay.
Oh, great. Oh, yeah.
by Samuel French.
The slide is back.
And the slide is reversed. But we had such fun with this show, didn't we?
Yes.
Yes. Lovely music. That's Eric Stengel on Picture Ride.
Fran Soder,
who's gone on and, you know, as a Broadway director, is next. I can't remember who played the lead.
Bob,
yeah. But Fran went on. Fran never finished his degree, went on, did a lot of stuff at K-Park, and became good friends with Stephen Sondheim, and travels all over the country now. He's a member of the director, you know, Society of Stage Directors and Choreographers. Great name. Okay. And Gene Shepherd choreographs. I don't know.
He was in Key West.
Is he still there?
And he's working at Boston.
Is he still working at Boston?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, this is the greatest spoof on the Busby Berkeley movies. Sing this is Rainy.
Yeah.
The Rainy number. Number, please.
74.
Thank you. And this was on this stage as well. Set, which shows you two rooms at the same time.
Tim. Come here, please.
Yeah, he was in Denver.
Was he in Denver?
Yeah, he was the last place.
Can you come back here, Tim, please?
Writing a book
store, I think.
Is there a place I can plug this in?
No, we're closed.
All right.
There she is at the end.
The battery's flashing.
Pulling it away. Getting off to another.
Yeah, the battery's probably going down. You probably don't have that much more time left on the cassette either.
Midsummer Night's Dream in Old East Hall. And this is 1973. And there's the Mylar curtain.
For what it's worth.
I could take through the window back here. Is there in the hall back here?
Out in the lobby.
Yeah. Well, I can.
How long's your cord?
I've got the original costume plates for this production, and it was done with a circus theme. And George Karras played Bottom. Bruce Brooks played Overall.
Okay. Well, I'll just go as long as I can.
Lily and Peggy were involved after 73.
Oh, okay. So, what, after this, you mean?
Well, as long as they're relatively sequential, they would have been out.
What year is this?
This is like 73.
That's the Mylar curtain from Dane.
So, you know, it seems to jump a little bit.
Yeah. Well, I'll just...
Just aren't any outlets.
Okay. Well, I'll just keep going until it... It's done. Till the battery's gone.
Of course, that building is long gone.
Thank you.
Howard did Macbeth, did he play there, Howard?
Yeah, we did. The first show we did.
Right.
David. And when did you?
And when?
Number one.
I don't know what happened to some of these slides. There's Rosie Pinaldo in the middle, and Kathy.
Beerhoff.
This is Under the Gaslight on this stage.
Oh my God.
And this is 1973, and then we took it that summer to Peninsula.
We sure did.
Right?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Department of State, and he's still in South Africa.
He is.
My brother. And there's the, he was this young white man who really wanted to be a black person. He was a drummer. Shame was the character's name.
She smoked.
Not? Gardone had just won the Pulitzer Prize for this play. I heard African American win the Pulitzer Prize.
Never wrote another.
And never wrote another play. The heavyset gentleman in the previous one is now a Muslim, and he's also a reenactor. He was in the rather recent production of Shenandoah. He's a reenactor, and I can't think of his the Muslim name, but he does all this stuff. And a number of these African American actors, I mean, we really got them involved in this, but then there was not much to follow up with. That's Ed Kaiser with the tie on. Howard, do you know where Ed is today?
He's teaching at the University of Oklahoma.
He was, the last time he was, yeah.
He got a doctorate in Detroit.
In Detroit, at Wayne State. And the shootout. And this young man, and he's played Gabe or the playwright. He's the voice of the playwright. And I never saw him after this show.
He was a substitute teacher in the African system. He left for a while and did something else, and then he ended up coming back. He's maybe a Firestone High School, a great teacher there. I mean, maybe that's where he had it.
Oh, I can check because
I'll think of it.
This is the Imaginary Invalid, the opening scene, which is like a little ballet. That's very quickly to show the little story. There's Ed Kaiser.
Where was this?
This was on this stage, and it was, I think this was a Larry Sexton set. In the middle, and he's still, I believe, at Brandeis, teaching at Brandeis. Now,
chorus.
Tim. Thank you. Appreciate the power.
I don't know how long the tape will
last. Oh, yeah, we'll see.
Sue Unsat was a GA. She did all those props. All those errors. Then last spring, we did to honor the anniversary of Brown versus the Board of Education. I wrote this little play called "We Conclude Unanimously," which was from the Supreme Court ruling. We did this is in Sanford Theater. We have the Supreme Court, which is they did a nice set here, and we have an actor to play Thurgood Marshall, and so on. And the Supreme Court were made up from prominent attorneys and judges and actors. Volunteered their time to come and do this. So it looked very impressive, the set, for what we do. It was called "We Conclude Unanimously." Creon in the foreground.
You showed half my body in that glass.
And there, yes, we did see the guy to Tiresias is here, and he was in the previous picture. And Marcy Belushi is upstage. There is the more recent Yocasta. Where is Marcy? Way back here. Telling the story of the killing three rows deep.
What number is this one? 32.
Four.
Hello, Jason.
Marcy, all of these belong to Arts Administration, so if you have any time, they go back to them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we can check. But these were phenomenal masks. Great ones. Here's Yocasta coming to the altar. It's a great picture.
Yeah, I like that one. So I can just check with yours?
Yes, because I'll get all.
Okay. 34. This one's 35.
And this was a much different Oedipus than the one in 74.
I was going on battery.
Oh, is that what you guys need?
Yeah, Tim hooked it up for me.
So, are you going to continue now?
Yeah.
Oh.
Might as well. These, they had more recent shots, and then these are some that they found from, I think, more of the years that you guys were down here.
Uh-huh. That's even key. Well, this is neat.
52. The last time I talked with her, she was in Detroit.
And what they're doing with the numbers, if you want to order something.
Oh, let's see. You're supposed to be writing numbers down.
Yeah, just call out a number if you want it. There was one that Tim ordered for you guys.
Denny Jacobs is in that.
Kay Spiegel. Tim ordered one for you of Kay Spiegel. When she was in something. They wanted to know what's Kay doing now. Tim said, ask Peggy. I hope you don't get dizzy watching this. What I'm trying to do is get the perspective of the whole picture and then zoom in on faces.
Oh, you can get tight on those pictures?
Well, kind of tight.
You have a good lens on it.
It's a nice little camera.
I mean, where were we,
camera? I mean, I don't know cameras, really, but I mean, yeah. I like this one. It's fun.
Love is a five-letter word of the mind.
So anyway, if you get seasick watching this, my intentions were good.
Definitely. How soon did they start? How long ago did they start?
I don't think they, see, I didn't get here till about 7, and I don't think they started till about maybe 8 o'clock, 7:30, quarter 8.
Oh, really? Then 61. You didn't miss them. What went on before that? Did they eat, right?
Oh, yeah. They ate. They had a group picture, name tags.
We're supposed to have name tags up?
Yeah, down at the front they have some.
Now, these are some of the better ones in Edward. These are really good spots.
So where is Bruce?
Bruce lives in town.
He lives on like Yellow Creek Road.
Yeah. Denny, I still have that crown. I use it in my Acting 1 class. It has one fake jewel left on it. This is a great picture.
How was practice?
65.
Really good.
Good.
Really good. They're coming along.
Yeah, it's nice, good weather for...
Oh, yeah, we were worried about it going to be raining and everything.
Oh, it was gorgeous. Yeah.
Real windy, though.
Yeah.
Boy, they got some practice chasing some wind-blown fly ball.
Yeah, well, I bet you the kids love it, though. A day like this just makes you want to be outside.
That was just us, so we degree our team.
We did have a lot of money, so we used turtlenecks for different colors. You know, I think yellows and gray. They made those, all the swords, and I have one, there's one left. Physical plant.
That's
made
the setup,
all those swords.
Oh, yeah. What's the set that had the ramps in it?
Atrius.
Yeah, okay. I saw the ramps, I recognize them.
That was a big set.
I remember those ramps because Lori and I used to play on them back in the shelter house. For a while, until stuff got piled on them, but I don't know, I remember doing something.
Number 68.
On those ramps.
Bought those pants somewhere in a little flea market store in Kansas.
What year was this?
71.
Yeah, he's here.
Oh, the sword.
You know, we lost
the sword.
70.
For Dave Pennelly and Jacobs. Dave Pennelly passed away. And Smith. 70. Dave, really, that sword is big as you.
I'm wondering how the focus will turn out on this, taking a picture of a picture. Yeah. Oh, we'll see.
It'll turn out however you've got it.
Yeah.
In your eyesight, I would imagine.
What TV are people of Starbucks?
79?
Stiggins? Yeah.
That was Pam Taylor.
You know what? It's hard for me to... this is black and white in my viewfinder.
Right.
You know?
No, I don't know where they are. I have three of our books.
Is there another tray or something?
Who's working the board tonight?
The board.
Who's on house lights tonight?
I don't know.
What are the TV monitors up there?
I don't know. They're going to have video later. He's got, some of them are.
Fly spirit.
but it's too far away.
Yeah.
I mean, I can see it. I can see it in the viewfinder.
Pam is going to go see about a plaque presentation.
Oh, okay. Do you want that?
If we can do it, yeah. Nobody's got it.
Oh, okay.
Someone asked, were we going to get Wallace anything, you know, kind of on his departure from the Jesus Museum? We said, no, that's not our problem, but we did anyhow. So this is kind of our little farewell party thing for Wallace.
Thank you.
called that.